Aloha, my friends. My name is Christopher, and I'd like to welcome you to a brand new edition of Morning Motivation. Today's quote comes to us from the great auto entrepreneur Henry Ford, and he says, "Nothing is particularly hard if you divide it into small jobs." You know, this reminds me so much of a fantastic other quote from one of our founding fathers, Benjamin Franklin, who said, "Little strokes fell great oaks." In other words, no matter how big or daunting the task may seem, if you simply chip away at it a little bit at a time, eventually the task will become completed. I know a lot of people out there who have some monumental goal that they would like to achieve, but they just don't know where to start because it seems so overwhelming. And I can tell you, if you are one of those people, no matter what your goal is, whether it be something like taking control of your health, whether it be something like stopping smoking or drinking, whatever the key is for you, the idea is simply this. Start small. If you want to go big and try and do it all at once, you can, but it's more difficult that way. It's always easier to start small. So, for instance, if we were to, let's suppose someone out there wants to quit smoking. So I'd ask them, number one, how many packs a day, or make it real simple, how many cigarettes a day do you smoke? Let's suppose they say 20. It's fairly average, I think. So why don't we say, okay, I tell you what, instead of just stopping, why don't you cut it down to 19? Why don't you take a single pack and say, okay, that's all I'm going to smoke, so whatever in this pack today. And whatever, I think there's 20 in a pack. I have no idea. I've never smoked before, but I think there's 20. Let's suppose you take out one. And you take that one cigarette and you throw it in the trash before you leave for the day. So now you only have 19 with you. And you do that for a week. Next week, you take out two. Throw it in the trash. Now you're down to 18. At the end of 20 weeks, my friends, you're a non-smoker. And I guarantee you, coming off of it like that, you're probably not going to have major withdrawal symptoms. You know, if you want to build a financial empire for yourself, for your family, for the people that haven't even been born yet, where do you start? Start with the first dollar. That's always a great place to start. You know, you can't jump into some major, major investment. You have to start small. So I remember years ago hearing someone talk about financial investing, and they said, you know what, if you want to be financially successful, you have to take care of your money. So if you want to take care of your money, why not take care of what you have already and start really simple? And he had everybody take their wallets or their purses out, and he said, okay, why don't you take whatever's in there right now and take care of it? And everybody's like, what are you talking about? He says, take the money out and make sure that it's organized in a very logical manner. In other words, from largest bill to smallest bill. You don't want to have stuff just wadded up and thrown in there. And he also said, if you have anything in your wallet outside of money, take it out because it doesn't belong there. A wallet is meant to hold cash. It's meant to hold credit cards, things like that. If you've got receipts in your wallet, if you've got coupons in your wallet, that's not the place for them. You want to create this environment, you want to create not only the environment for the money, but you want to create the mental attitude of, my money is important and it doesn't belong in a junk heap, all right? And so that's a great place to begin. I remember hearing years ago someone talking about, I believe it was actually a gentleman in the YouTube painting community. He said, you know, if I wanted to start an ice cream shop, I wouldn't start by buying a shop. I'd start by buying an ice cream cart. And I'd take that into the city, and I'd wheel it around all day long. And I would use that cart to build up financially so that I could put a down payment on an ice cream shop. What a concept, starting small. You know, if your goal is to become a real estate multi-millionaire or billionaire, you're obviously not going to go out and buy the Transamerica Pyramid or Trump Tower or the Sears Tower or something like that, You're going to go out, you're going to buy or rent or purchase, I guess would be the best way to say. You're going to purchase maybe a single unit apartment. Or you might purchase a small house. Or you might even purchase a room from someone and then try to rent it out. Start small, my friends. And little changes over time will ensure that you meet your goal. What if we approached everything in life with the idea of, it's just too far, I don't know how to achieve it. And you wanted to go on vacation. Let's suppose that you wanted to go to Disney World down in Orlando, Florida. It's a great place to go. I've been there myself. How do you get there? Well, let's suppose that you live in, I don't know, I'm not going to pick California because they have Disneyland, so it'd be a lot quicker to go there. But let's suppose you live in Virginia. If you live in Virginia and you want to go to Disney World, it's a big journey. It's a big trip. So how do you make it? Well, it's real simple. You take step number one. Step number one is walk out your door. You say, that's stupid. I know. It's easy and simple. Step number one is walk out your door. What's step number two? Real easy. Get in your car. There you go. Or get in the taxi. Either one. If it's getting the taxi, then step number one is call the taxi company. Step number two is walk out your door. Step number three is get in the taxi. What's step number four? Drive to the airport. Get out of your car. Step number five. Step number six, go to the terminal. Step number seven, get on the plane. Very simple. But we don't think of it in steps like that, do we? We just think of it in one big chunk. I'm going to Disney World. Here we go. But when we have something really, really important in our lives that we think is just so monumentally big, that's still how we think of it, unfortunately. Because we're so used to thinking like that, we don't break it down into its smaller segments. So it's a great way to approach things, and I would encourage you to do something like that. So pick a goal or something that you've got that seems daunting. Let's suppose you wanted to write a book, for instance. If you wanted to write a 300-page book, and I told you, you had to write this 300-page book by the end of the year, you might find that a task that's just overwhelming. But what if I told you that instead of writing a 300-page, coffee table size, page-turning bestseller by the end of the year, what if I told you you had to write three quarters of a page of words every day? And that's all you had to do. Well, that's a lot more feasible, isn't it? But by the end of the year, 365 days in a year, three quarters of a page a day is going to get you your 300-page book. It's just how you look at it, my friends. So remember, whatever you've got that's daunting and that's in front of you, pick something big. Pick something that you really want to do, but you just feel like it's overwhelming for you. And then just come up with what you think the first step ought to be. And take step number one. And once you take step number one, figure out what step number two is going to be. And take step number two. And just start moving towards your goals. It's so easy, and it's so simple. And I would encourage you to implement this idea in your life. That the idea is, if you have something big, simply break it down into something small. So, that's all I got for you guys today. I hope that you enjoyed this edition of Morning Motivation. I hope that you apply what you've learned to your life. That's the point of these, is to help you to become a better person and to help you achieve more than you would ordinarily have achieved otherwise. But anyway, I really do hope that you have enjoyed it. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you again for watching. I really, really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day. And remember, remain diligent in everything that you do.